There is a fucking ridiculous debate going on in this country between people who think that we should have stricter gun control and those who want to be able to defend themselves. And the rhetoric of this, the politicization of this is just, it's offensive. Because not that it's being politicized, but that it's being politicized in a way that it's taking people's fear and using it to manipulate people into serving political agendas. But I guess it's kind of how politics works, isn't it? And now we have a whole series of incidents on the issue that maybe wouldn't have been picked up by the national media if it wasn't in the wake of the Colorado shooting. But for all the fear-mongering about this being some false flag attack and a psyop designed to get people to support the UN gun treaty and arms control in general, we have a very exciting story, actually, two very exciting stories here that are examples of people being armed, being able to protect themselves in cases of irrational violence. This first one comes from Salt Lake City, ABC 4 News. Gun-carrying man ends stabbing spree at Salt Lake grocery store. A citizen with a gun stopped a knife-wielding man as he began stabbing people Thursday evening at the downtown Salt Lake City Smith's store. Police say the suspect purchased a knife inside the store and then turned it into a weapon. Smith's employee, Dorothy Espinosa, says he pulled it out and stood outside the Smith's in the foyer and just started stabbing people and yelling, "You killed my people, you killed my people." Espinosa says the knife-wielding man seriously injured two people. There is blood all over. One got stabbed in the stomach and got stabbed in the head and held his hands and got stabbed all over the arms. Then, before the suspect could find another victim, a citizen with a gun stopped the madness. Quote, "A guy pulled a gun on him and told him to drop his weapon or he would shoot him. So he dropped his weapon and the people from Smith's grabbed him." It works. Simple as that. I mean, the thing is, these are the incidents that happen all the time that go unreported because nobody cares. Oh, well, nobody died. You know, it was a tragedy averted. And nobody, when they see the actual tragedy happen as it did in Colorado, go, well, geez, how has this ever been prevented in the past? Dozens of other shoppers who too could have become victims are also thankful for the gun-carrying man, and many, like Daniel Julian, are still in shock from the experience. Scary, actually, really scary. 5 minutes before I walk out to my car, it could have been me. Police say right now they have no idea what caused the suspect to go on the dangerous rampage. We will update as soon as we learn new information. So far, police have not released the names of the suspect, the victims, or the man who pulled the gun. The real tragedy about this story, though, there is a tragedy here, is that in most places, what the man did would have been illegal. Carrying a concealed weapon in a lot of places is simply completely illegal. Without a permit, in most places, completely illegal. And in a lot of places, carrying, for a lot of people, owning a gun itself is simply illegal. But it's not just about guns, because we have another incident, this from Silver Spring, Maryland, from CBS DC. Man stabbed at Silver Spring post office after another man mistakenly thought he cut in line. Now, because there wasn't a gun involved, you don't have the sensationalism in the story. But I would just like to point out that while I'm advocating people engage in the responsible ownership and use of firearms for self-defense, it's not just about guns. If you are maybe in a position where, hey, guns a bit too much, maybe it's illegal where I am. You know what? The government has not cut off all mechanisms for you to be able to protect yourself. Now, in the District of Columbia, which is really fucking pathetic, pepper spray and tasers are illegal. But pepper spray, tasers, I'm not such a big fan of, although they certainly have their place. If that's what you choose, more power to you. But I, having been pepper sprayed myself, am a big fan of pepper spray as a self-defense tool. And in this case, the headline, "Man stabbed at Silver Spring post office after another man mistakenly thought he cut a line," could have been, "Pepper spray carrying postal worker ends stabbing at post office." But no, we're not going to celebrate in a case where it's slightly less blatant because there isn't a gun involved, that a citizen without the help of law enforcement actually successfully defended another citizen. A 58-year-old man suffered serious injuries when he was stabbed by another patron at a Silver Spring post office Thursday afternoon. Police believe the incident occurred following a confrontation between the two shortly after 2:15 p.m. Wednesday at the post office located in the 13,200 block of New Hampshire Avenue. The victim got up to the postal window but was told he would need to fill out more paperwork before completing his transaction. He was allowed to finish filling out the forms off to the side of the window and then come straight back to the counter. A 67-year-old man who was waiting in line apparently thought the man was cutting in line when he returned to the window. He exited the post office and waited for in the vestibule for the victim to leave. The suspect then stabbed the 58-year-old victim, at which point two female postal employees intervened. At least one of the women deployed pepper spray in an attempt to subdue the attacker. I hate, maybe it's really insignificant, but I just hate how that's buried in the story. They intervened because they're postal workers. Oh, and by the way, one of them had pepper spray. Really? Authorities believe their intervention may have saved the man's life. The suspect was able to get away in his vehicle. However, a Montgomery County police officer spotted the suspect in his car and pulled him over roughly 1 mile away at the intersection of New Hampshire Avenue and Maryland Route 29. He was then taken into custody. The victim's injuries are described as serious but non-life-threatening. Well, I guess if he was driving away, whatever he got hit with the pepper spray must not have been very effective, because he certainly didn't get it in the face if he was driving. But maybe he inhaled enough. He must have inhaled enough that it irritated him, that he realized he was being confronted and he walked and he decided to run away. And that's usually all it takes. But I want to point out a video here that's also been released in the wake of the Colorado shooting. This is titled Run, Hide, Fight, Surviving an Active Shooter Event. And I found this from federalnewsradio.com. The headline is DHS-funded video gives tips to survive a shooter. After last week's shooting at a movie theater in Aurora, Colorado, the city of Houston has released a how-to video on surviving a shooter event. The video was created with funds from the Homeland Security Department. According to Mayor Anise Parker, in a statement, she said, "I can't imagine the horror and grief. If it is at all possible for any good to come out of it, perhaps it can be letting people know the options to consider if it happens again." Right, because you need to know your options when someone starts shooting at you. Although, it would be nice to know your options in advance. Unfortunately, a lot of those options in terms of self-defense have been taken away by government. But specifically here, it gets even worse, because this is like a kind of honey, poison statism thing. Like you said, the title of the video is Run, Hide, Fight. And that's generally good advice. I mean, if you're unarmed, like at least if you're unarmed, and most Americans are, so to be fair, recognizing that, if someone is coming after you, shooting at you, run. No shit. I don't think you really need a government video to tell you that, right? But it's good advice. And they've got some examples of how to run and how to coordinate with others. And yeah, it kind of makes sense, okay? Run if a safe path is available. Always try to escape or evacuate even if others insist on staying. Encourage others to leave with you, but don't let the indecision of others slow you down or slow down your own effort to escape. Once you're out of the line of fire, try to prevent others from walking into the danger zone. Call 911. If you can't get out safely, find a place to hide. Yeah, when hiding, turn out lights. Remember to lock doors and silence your ringer and vibration mode on your cell phone. As a last resort, working together or alone, act with aggression, use improvised weapons, and fight.
As a last resort, if your life is at risk, whether you are alone or working together as a group, fight. Act with aggression. Improvise weapons. Disarm him. And commit to taking the shooter down, no matter what.
Oh my God. Do I feel sorry for those poor saps in the office in that scene, wielding chairs and a fire extinguisher against a man wielding a shotgun. Because the one thing they don't tell you to do is to be armed. Right, because the government doesn't want you to challenge their monopoly on the use of force. They don't want you to challenge their monopoly on providing for the public safety. They want it to be a last resort. The very last, like, really, okay, so if you have an opportunity to fight someone who's going around on a rampage shooting people, you shouldn't stop them except as a last resort. You should run and let them keep killing people if you have a chance to stop them, because then it wouldn't be a last resort. So the very message here that is being put out by the city of Houston and the Department of Homeland Security is going to get someone killed eventually. This practice that they are advocating is going to get people killed. Now, the way you actually prevent this from happening is by looking out for the mental health of your fellow citizens. No shit. That's how you prevent it from happening in the first place. But once it's happening, the way you stop it is the same way the government stops it. They're saying, run, hide, fight. But the point is so that you can get out of the way of the government agents who are highly trained who are going to take out the shooter. I mean, even someone with pepper spray. I mean, I guess this wouldn't work in the case of the Colorado shooting and the gas mask, but a taser, you'd be so much better off if you were armed in some way and capable of resisting, capable of providing for your own defense. And oh my God, I feel so sorry for anybody who's in that situation. But even in this little video, I look at the people in the office and I'm like, oh my God, it's a chair and a coffee maker and a fire extinguisher versus a shotgun. This is how the government wants you to be able to fight for your life. Sad, isn't it?